There are a lot of people who don't know what they love doing. Aren't you having trouble finding out what you want to do in life? After you watch this video, you'll feel unloaded from this burden. This video is made by taking away the key points from a Japanese business book written by Yuigo Kitano. In the last part of this video, I'll be sharing the most important message, so stick around to the very end. Okay, let's dive right into it. There are two types of people. To-do type and being type. To-do type is someone who has a clear goal and dream on what to do in life. To create a new product or to become a famous athlete or entrepreneur. They focus on thinking of what to do. A being type is someone who thinks more of their state. What kind of person they want to be or what kind of environment they want to be in is important. It might be to have a job that they're surrounded by the people they respect. Or being able to work in an environment without any stress. Only 1% out there are the to-do type who have a clear dream and goal. The rest of the 99% are the being type who think their state of who they are and surrounded with is more important. There is no scientific proof about this ratio, but there are only a handful of people who can set a clear goal in life and strive towards it. And the shocking news is most of the books and advices from successful people in the world are written by a to-do type. They tell you to do what you love, but unfortunately the method and approach is different from what the being type needs. The being types usually get lost on what to do. Many entrepreneurs and influencers say do what you love. It will increase your market value and will bring you new opportunities. This personally fully resonates with me. But whenever a being type hears this, they say to themselves, holy smoke, I need to find what I love. But the truth of the matter is this. You don't need to clearly know what you love. You don't need clarity. You need to do what you think you might love, but it doesn't have to be crystal clear. If you're a being type, you don't need a clear goal or dream. But what do you need? For a being type to enjoy their job, they need to 1. Increase their market value. 2. Choose the right balance of the difficulty level of their job and their ability. Let me explain. This means in gaming, for example, it doesn't matter which type of game you play. Whether it's a racing game or RPG or shooting game. Just focus on improving your level in any game and choose the right stage that fits your current ability. Do you feel you're increasing your market value in your current job? Is your job challenging enough or is it too easy? Are you in the right stage? If not, maybe it's time for you to change your environment. If you're a being type, don't be discouraged that you can't find what you love doing. Instead, you can find out what you quite love doing. The secret is to find something from what you don't hate, not necessarily from what you love. Not much people are certain that they're doing what they love. Don't put too much pressure on yourself. It's fine as long as the job you're doing isn't painful. Most of the people who are able to achieve huge success in life are the people who have experience doing a job that they don't hate and achieved huge results there. In most cases, it was a coincidence. Those people were put in a situation that they had to work extremely hard and were able to get the results and make someone happy. Those experiences are the tipping point when a job that they don't hate turns into something they quite love. Adding value is the juice of doing a good job in any field. What you need to avoid is to not do anything and be lazy just because you haven't found what you love doing. Not doing anything is a bad place you want to be stuck in. Choose something from what you don't hate and work on developing your skills so that you can turn it into something you're good at. If you get the results, it might not be something that can change the world, but it should become something you love doing to a certain degree. And that's actually enough. Another trick to keep you motivated is to label yourself. Say to yourself, I'm an expert in sales, or I'm an expert in quality control, or whatever. Put a slogan on yourself. Believe it or not, you'll start changing your life. The good thing about this is that you'll get laser focused on your expertise. Whenever you get off track, the label you put on yourself will push you to be that kind of person. The affirmation of I am will always keep you on the right foot and make you take the right actions. Focus is power. When people who haven't yet decided what kind of person they are or what they want to be, the power is spread all over the place. Label yourself and increase your market value on something. In the future, living costs will be cut down and people will be categorized into 3. 1. People who love doing their job. 2. People cutting their time working and focusing on their hobbies. 3. People who keep on doing a job they hate. Unfortunately, I think roughly 50 to 80% keep on doing a job they hate in today's world. But technology will advance and eliminate jobs that people hate doing. People will start moving more on what they love doing or focusing on their hobbies. Don't you think this will be such a wonderful world to live in? I mean, nobody could have imagined this 30 years ago, right? So, to sum up, there are two types of people. A to-do type are the people who have a clear dream or goal on what to do. A being type are those who think their state of who they are or the environment they belong in is important. Most of us are being type, so it's okay if you don't know what your goal or dream in life is. You just need to start working on what you don't hate and focus on increasing your market value. Eventually, you will find out what you quite love. The world will turn into a place where people are doing what they love or at least reduce work and then focusing on hobbies. In that kind of world, it's crucial to find out what you quite love or love 100% to have a happy life. If you want to find your purpose in life, the next video to watch is this. And if you're new here, hi, my name is Joey and this channel is all about self-development tips to change your mindset and changing your life. So if this sounds good to you, please consider subscribing, hit that notification bell. If you like this video, go click on the like button and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.